in his movie from 1979, All That Jazz, that has stuck with me, because it talks about not only his philosophy, but really kind of what we do here at Toastmasters. His alter ego in the movie is rehearsing a Broadway show, and one of the dancers is having some trouble. She just can't quite do his work the way he wants her to. And he's a perfectionist. Everything's got to be just so. And he's riding her really hard. Well, actually, he's riding her in more than one way because he's sleeping with her. He's cheating on his girlfriend, who is played by Anne Reinking, who is Fosse's real-life girlfriend at the time. Wow. So, and she just finally has a total meltdown in rehearsal. She says, I can't get it. I'll never get it. I should quit. I should leave right now. And there's this moment, and he says, listen, I can't make you a great dancer. I don't even know if I can make you a good dancer. But if you try hard and you don't quit, I know I can make you a better dancer. And that's what I'd like to do. Stay? And she says, are you going to keep yelling at me? He says, probably. So she stays, and she gets the step, and she's in the show at the end. Or at least we think she is, because we don't get to that point. But that's not really relevant here. Now, the title of my speech is Missing Pieces. It comes from a realization I had several years ago. That there were some missing pieces in Toastmasters here in Austin. For one thing, there's persuasion as a subject is a missing piece in Toastmasters in general. Now, this is an advanced manual called The Persuasive Speaker. What it is the Persuasive Salesperson Manual, which was probably the Persuasive Salesman Manual, even before I first saw it, with a new cover. It's the same 1990s era sales advice, and they've just relabeled it the Persuasive Speaking. So, Toastmasters doesn't really talk about persuasion as much as I think it should. Also, politics. We live in a democracy. In a democracy, speech, public speaking, persuasion is important. But Toastmasters doesn't have a manual about politics. There's a public relations manual, but that doesn't seem to fit the job. And I think there should be more about politics in Toastmasters. And finally, the missing piece, here in Austin. We have about 70 Toastmasters clubs here in this town. We have a number of people who are liberals and progressives, but we don't have a club dedicated to liberals and progressives. And I thought, let's start one. Call it the Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters. A club to teach persuasive skills for people who are of the liberal progressive persuasion. I had this idea in 2012. Well, it's not 2012, it's 2015. So there may be a couple of questions you have right now. Why the delay? Well, my problem is, one of my problems is that I have trouble asking for help. So it's taken me this long to get to the point where I can say, hey, would someone like to help me with this? But 3 weeks ago, the Tuesday after the first Monday of November, which, as you know, is the definition of Election Day in the United States, I got on Facebook and I said, I'm going to start a club called Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters. I'm putting it out there. And you've got to be brave. The second question you might have, though, is why am I here? Why am I here at AGLCC? I've already said, I'm asking for help. So why am I asking you guys for help? Well, I think for one thing, there may be one or two progressives here. There may be, but I don't assume everyone here is. Or that if you're even not opposed to the idea that you're politically active. I don't assume that. Living in Austin, you think, everyone's progressive. And then you find out, no, not everyone in this town is progressive. But more importantly than that, you guys know some things. Toastmasters, it said that you cannot talk about three things: sex, religion, or politics. Now there are clubs where you can talk about your religion. And you guys know you can talk about sex. So you can probably figure out, yeah, you can talk about that in Toastmasters. You also know about continuing a struggle, even in the face of setbacks. Even when it doesn't, looks like things are not going to ever go your way. Some of you go back to the 80s, know about the gay rights struggle in the 80s. Some of you, have personal memories of people who didn't make it here. So, you know about not quitting, not giving up, continuing the struggle. And here at HDLCC, you know the value of a club that is designed to appeal to a community. There's a marketing guy named Seth Godin, and his thing, one of the things in one of his fairly recent books, about 10 years ago, fairly recent, said and talks about a restaurant in New York that they design dishes to fit their customers rather than trying to find customers to fit their idea of a restaurant. And I thought, yeah, pick a community and build a club to appeal to those prospective members rather than having a sort of general purpose club and trying to find members to fit that club. You guys know the importance, the value of that, because here in AGLCC, you have a club that is designed to appeal to a community. So what would be the benefits of starting a new club like this? Well, for one thing, starting a new club means you can work toward your goals in Toastmasters. Sponsoring a club in Toastmasters, or being a mentor to a club in Toastmasters, earns you credit toward your Advanced Leadership Silver Award. Another thing you can do is you can help build a Toastmasters club that's easy to talk about to your liberal and progressive friends. How many of you here are on Facebook?
Yep.
And you know you've got some friends that are not politically interested at all. And you've got some friends maybe that are, politically interested one way or the other. And you think, boy, I wish I could talk to some of those people and get them to Toastmasters. This would be a way to talk about something, a Toastmasters club that you could talk about to liberals and progressives. And finally, you could help build a club that will teach persuasion skills, leadership skills, to someone who might run for city council, or the state senate, or the U.S. House of Representatives, or even the presidency. So you could do something that really makes a difference. Now, Anne Ryan came in the PBS tribute to Bob Fosse, said this little thing. She said, there's a tradition in the world of dance that you pass on what you know. And I think that's a tradition we should adopt in Toastmasters too. So if you're a liberal or progressive, or you just think this could be a fun idea, so I invite you to pass on what you know. Help me put together the missing pieces and build a new club, the Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters. In his movie from 1979, All That Jazz, that has stuck with me, because it talks about not only his philosophy, but really kind of what we do here at Toastmasters. His alter ego in the movie is rehearsing a Broadway show, and one of the dancers is having some trouble. She just can't quite do his work the way he wants her to. And he's a perfectionist. Everything's got to be just so. And he's riding her really hard. Well, actually, he's riding her in more than one way because he's sleeping with her. He's cheating on his girlfriend, who is played by Anne Reinking, who was Fosse's real life girlfriend at the time.
Wow.
So, and she just finally has a total meltdown in rehearsal. She says, I can't get it, I'll never get it, I should quit, I should leave right now. And there's this moment, and he says, listen, I can't make you a great dancer. I don't even know if I can make you a good dancer. But if you try hard and you don't quit, I know I can make you a better dancer. And that's what I'd like to do. Stay? And she says, are you going to keep yelling at me? He says, probably. So she stays, and she gets the step, and she's in the show at the end. Or at least we think she is, because we don't get to that point. But that's not really relevant here. Now, the title of my speech is Missing Pieces. It comes from a realization I had several years ago. There were some missing pieces in Toastmasters here in Austin. For one thing, there's persuasion as a subject is a missing piece in Toastmasters in general. Now, this is an advanced manual called The Persuasive Speaker. What it is the Persuasive Salesperson Manual, which was probably the Persuasive Salesman Manual, even before I first saw it, with a new cover. It's the same 1990s era sales advice, and they've just relabeled it the Persuasive Speaking. So Toastmasters doesn't really talk about persuasion as much as I think it should. Also, politics. We live in a democracy. In a democracy, speech, public speaking, persuasion is important. But Toastmasters doesn't have a manual about politics. There's a public relations manual, but that doesn't seem to fit the job. And I think there should be more about politics in Toastmasters. And finally, the missing piece here in Austin. We have about 70 Toastmasters clubs here in this town. We have a number of people who are liberals and progressives, but we don't have a club dedicated to liberals and progressives. And I thought, let's start one. Call it the Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters. A club to teach persuasive skills for people who are of the liberal progressive persuasion. I had this idea in 2012. Well, it's not 2012. It's 2015. So there may be a couple of questions you have right now. Why the delay? Well, my problem is, one of my problems is that I have trouble asking for help. So it's taken me this long to get to the point where I can say, hey, would someone like to help me with this? But 3 weeks ago, on the Tuesday after the first Monday of November, which, as you know, is the definition of Election Day in the United States, I got on Facebook and I said, I'm going to start a club called Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters. I'm putting it out there. And you've got to be brave. The second question you might have, though, is why am I here? Why am I here at AGLCC? I've already said, I'm asking for help. So why am I asking you guys for help? Well, I think for one thing, there may be one or two progressives here. There may be, but I don't assume everyone here is. Or that if you're not opposed to the idea that you're politically active. I don't assume that. Living in Austin, you think, everyone's progressive. And then you find out, no, not everyone in this town is progressive. But more importantly than that, you guys know some things. Toastmasters, it's said that you cannot talk about three things: sex, religion, or politics. Now, there are clubs where you can talk about your religion. And you guys know you can talk about sex. So you can probably figure out, yeah, you can talk about that in Toastmasters. You also know about continuing a struggle, even in the face of setbacks, even when it looks like things are not going to ever go your way. Some of you go back to the 80s. You know about the gay rights struggle in the 80s. some of you, have personal memories of people who didn't make it here. So, not quitting, not giving up, continuing the struggle. And here at HDLCC, you know the value of a club that is designed to appeal to a community. There's a marketing guy named Seth Godin, and his thing, one of the things in one of his fairly recent books, about 10 years ago, fairly recent, said and talks about a restaurant in New York that they design dishes to fit their customers rather than trying to find customers to fit their idea of a restaurant. And I thought, yeah, pick a community and build a club to appeal to those prospective members rather than having a sort of general purpose club and trying to find members to fit that club. You guys know the importance, the value of that, because here in AGLCC, you have a club that is designed to appeal to a community. So what would be the benefits of starting a new club like this? Well, for one thing, starting a new club means you can work toward your goals in Toastmasters. Sponsoring a club in Toastmasters, or being a mentor to a club in Toastmasters, earns you credit toward your Advanced Leadership Silver Award. Another thing you can do is you can help build a Toastmasters club that's easy to talk about to your liberal and progressive friends. How many of you here are on Facebook?
Yep.
And you know you've got some friends that are not politically interested at all. And you've got some friends maybe that are politically interested one way or the other. And you think, boy, I wish I could talk to some of those people and get them to Toastmasters. This would be a way to talk about something, a Toastmasters club that you could talk about to liberals and progressives. And finally, you can help build a club that will teach persuasion skills, leadership skills, to someone who might run for city council, or the state senate, or the U.S. House of Representatives, or even the presidency. So you can do something that really makes a difference. Now, Anne Ryan King, in the PBS tribute to Bob Fosse, said this little thing. She said, there's a tradition in the world of dance that you pass on what you know. And I think that's a tradition we should adopt in Toastmasters, too. So if you're a liberal or progressive, or you just think this could be a fun idea, so I invite you to pass on what you know. Help me put together the missing pieces and build a new club, the Progressive Persuasion Toastmasters.